The war in Ukraine has not been confined to land, sea, and air. There's also a secretive and important war effort in space. Intel gathered from satellites has been an important part of how Ukraine has been able to fight back against Russian invaders.
Space has always been militarized. The dynamic that's shifting is the weaponization of space.
As our political and military leadership are telling us, it is a war-fighting domain.
Private companies have released imagery from their satellites which have shown Russian operations and even likely war crimes, all seen from space. And at the forefront of all of this is the U.S. Space Force.
We've been collaborating with private industry, you know, 4 years now, and certainly we increased that activity as the presence of commercial industry increases in space.
Well, keep in mind, that's what really provides us for having the edge over any other country in the world. We really have a great partnership between our Department of Defense and those companies who make their own personal investments.
Private companies like Maxar Technologies, which takes images from orbit, and SpaceX, which has provided its Starlink space-based broadband system. The future of warfare is in space, and the Space Force is going to play a big role in how it unfolds. The importance of space-based assets to Ukraine's preparedness may have helped tip the balance in favor of Kyiv in the early days of the war.
The United States government continues to be a really critical customer for the space industry, specifically for different national security services. Beyond providing rocket launches for government customers, whether they're classified or not.
Any conflict involves space. You know, we use space for satellite communications and for precision navigation and timing. Certainly in a conflict that that the United States was involved in, we would be critical to the joint force operations.
We now have the ability to, with our satellites and our space capabilities, to identify all the activities that are going on the ground.
The space industry also has been increasingly providing other services, such as satellite imagery. A good recent example is the conflict in Ukraine and a lot of the imagery that we're seeing out of what's happening on the ground in Ukraine, whether that's Russian troop movement or that's Ukrainian military advances.
For example, also, Russia has said that they have not been committing war crimes, but yet our satellites were able to pick up all the carnage and the actual bodies strewn on the side of the streets that they claimed they had no part of, but yet we now are able to see it.
Different U.S. companies have been providing imagery, sometimes on an hour-by-hour basis, of situations of interest in Ukraine.
For decades, there's been a steady drumbeat calling for a specific U.S. military branch dedicated to space. Until recently, it was a job for the Air Force.
The creation of the Space Force was not without controversy, as the United States Air Force already had the U.S. Space Command underneath it.
The Space Force has around 16,000 personnel assigned and a budget of $24.5 billion. Compare this to the Air Force, which has over 300,000 airmen on active duty and a budget of $194 billion.
We want to maintain that advantage, maintain that free use of space for U.S. companies to go and operate in the domain safely.
The Space Force's main mission is to organize, train, and equip our military forces to be able to deal with our national security assets in space. So this means both acquiring satellites, contracting for them to be designed, built, and launched into space, then operating those satellites, receiving that data, and processing it.
It's the ground infrastructure that matters a lot right now. People might be disappointed that there's not going to be, at least in the moment, a bunch of armed astronauts and weaponized spacecraft running around hunting enemies like they might see in Star Wars or something. But it's really important that we have the right, sensing capabilities, communications capabilities, anything that goes up and down from the Earth.
As the Space Force mission expands, there have been calls for a Space National Guard as well.
I think really making sure that we have a separate standalone National Guard Space Force section really allows us to make sure we deal with the intersection between our domestic trained National Guard and the support that they provide for the warfighters.
The explosion in private space access has been rapid.
One of the primary ways that companies across the space ecosystem interact with the U.S. Space Force is through different types of services. One of the most well-known ones and high profile is that of launch services through a variety of different programs, typically launching different types of government satellites of all shapes and sizes, whether they're small satellites that are riding along with rockets such as Virgin Orbit or Astra, or they're much larger satellites on very expensive missions for the United Launch Alliance, which is a joint venture of Boeing and Lockheed Martin, or with SpaceX, which are the two main large heavy rocket builders here in the United States.
Really, Space Systems Command out in Los Angeles as part of the Space Force really is the front runner in this. So there is an opportunity for new starts and small business mentoring to happen.
For example, in my region, commercial space is scheduled to grow dramatically over the next decade. And so again, it's not only good for the economy and providing jobs, but it's good all the way around for our national defense as well.
Besides the big household names, other companies like Maxar and Hawkeye 360, among others, are providing important services to the U.S. government.
These companies continue to both develop their products as well as demonstrate to the United States government how they can provide different services that the government would like to purchase.
Much like how the Navy keeps ocean trade lanes open, the Space Force will help commercial operations dodge space junk, keep track of potential space pitfalls, and provide information as the use of space becomes even bigger.
The United States government continues to be a really critical customer for the space industry, specifically for different national security services. Beyond providing rocket launches for government customers, whether they're classified or not,
we need to establish international norms where we get as many countries as possible to sign up to adhere to those standards and norms, like we did with the Geneva Convention for conflicts. We need to do that for space, because there's real implications for the debris, the proliferation of debris in space.
Russia and China remain a key concern as competitors in the field of space-based militarization.
China probably has more sophisticated counter-space weaponry, and they also have more sophisticated space assets. Generally, they have a lot more at stake in space. They're investing a lot, but we cannot ignore Russia, obviously. I mean, they've demonstrated that they are willing to use some counter space weapons in conflict in Ukraine. These are weapons that we've tracked for years. We knew they had. And so you can't fully ignore Russia in favor of China. You kind of have to be able to, you know, deter both.
The U.S. Space Force is also involved in looking at newer technologies and how they could fit into the future of the U.S.'s national security apparatus in space.
U.S. Space Force continues to look at different ways it can seed the industry's development, either through different contracts to small rocket launch companies that are really starting to come into the fore in terms of providing services to deliver payloads to orbit, or through experimental kind of next generation programs. One such example would be the rocket cargo program. That's an idea of using rockets to deliver payloads and other services from one point on the Earth to another point on the Earth and back. Those different types of systems offer a capability in which something that would maybe traditionally fly via a very large cargo aircraft over several hours or days could be delivered within an hour from one point in the United States to anywhere in the world.
Although new, the Space Force is dedicated to producing its own culture that furthers warfighting capability in space.
As we separate and we become, you know, not air-minded airmen like we were in the Air Force, but really thinking about space power, thinking about the space domain and how to operate, that's absolutely the culture that we're building right now.